Once again, yes, yes, Iris.
Hey, I'm Chris Dyer. I like to travel the world with art, having fun, and meeting interesting people.
Once again,
I hope you enjoyed this adventure.
We tackle rhymes like your life lays time. We trying to get it up, we gotta fill up. Before it's all gone, the song remains on until the beat stops. Never mind, no need to remind, you know who we be. Yo, it's the capital G's, putting the P's in hip hop. Saying hi to the hoes who wear hardly any clothes. Here's looking at you, watching me, the incredible MC. Chicks call me Mikey,
why's that?
Cause I like it. They stare when I'm digging it and know they wanna try. They like the way I rap, they like the way I chill. Couple hours in a conversation, show them how I thrill. I'm a 1 minute man, I lick it then, split it, empty it out. Fill it in like the blank and I'm out. Big Mike, that's right, give him some.
Damn, some beautiful side touch here. Don't fuck with this guy.
Me and the homie make music and they coming with bulls. So next time they gotta rhyme that place, I'll throw it away. People learn to save the day. Sometimes it ain't time, sometimes it can't be. This time we kick back and let your conscience be free. The music is playing loud and we never have.
Hey, welcome back to the Artventures. In this episode, I am in Vienna in the country of Austria. I will be here to teach visionary art work in an academy and just check as much cool art as I can. It's a beautiful place with great architecture so far.
Yeah, it's an interesting city. Rich, cultural, pretty amazing, diverse. It's got its ups, its downs, but it keeps me interested. You know, it's, I think, being part of history, being here, was the cool part.
And I'm the co-director of the Vienna Academy of Visionary Art. The idea of the academy is to bring in artists, teachers who are transmitting their technique from the oil technique, like mesh technique. That's why we're here, to transmit mostly the mesh technique that most of our teachers have learned with the master Ernst Fuchs, but also we're opening to other kinds of techniques like acrylics, UV colors and so on. So it's really to give the people the tools to render their visions. We really let the people decide what they want to paint. We actually lead them sometimes through meditations and inner journeys to find their ideas, to help them really find their images. But then the images is their own. We don't impose, you should paint this or you should paint that.
The Visionary Art Academy that we have here in Vienna is expanding, and that it's increasing its outreach into the community, not just here in Vienna, but also internationally. We're getting more students from around the world, from India, from Saudi Arabia, from South America, as well as Europe and North America and Australia. And so it's really becoming one of the hubs within the international community of visionary art. And we feel it, how visionary art's expanding across the globe and forming these networks. And pretty soon, I think we're going to realize that visionary art is the art of today, because it's an eternal art. An eternal art has always been there, will always be there. And we are just tapping into those traditions that are truly the inheritance of all humanity, and we're just part of that.
It's a really nice place to release your creativity. From the moment you enter the space, you feel a vibration of energy and a positive one. And just from that moment, you start falling more in love with the space and the people, and everyone is so welcoming and friendly. And it's an incredible place, to say the least.
So the academy is a really beautiful place, and just really open-minded, art-loving, beautiful people come here. I've learned so much while I've been here. Just like learning with the teachers I really look up to, and being in such a community, it just really builds you up.
So yeah, it's just a great container for learning new techniques and evolving as an artist, and with really great people from all over the world, fantastic facilitators who put nothing but love into it. And me, it's like, this is where I belong, and I feel that every day.
So in the fall trimester, 2017, and the trimester is divided in two parts. We just had 5 weeks with Luke Brown, and now we're just starting 5 other weeks with Chris Dyer.
I love Arts and Faros. They're so fantastic. They've been the ultimate hosts and so accommodating on so many levels. 5 weeks was an intensive painting course, teaching all of my techniques to 15 eager minds. It was fantastic. It turned out so much better than I could have imagined. I didn't really know what I was stepping into. I didn't really know what the vibe was going to be, or what the, you know, the skill levels. I had no clue what I was walking into. I had no reference other than just trusting in Lawrence and Florence and all the other people that have been here before, and all the vibes that have been shared with me of what's been going on here. And so, yeah, that's what I was walking in with. And yeah, it turned out so much better than I could have imagined, and it was so much more fun than I had imagined it was going to be. So yeah, I'm so stoked to have had this opportunity to do this, and I'm stoked that you're here too, and you get to follow with, you know, the same set of students, and
yeah, it'll
continue
be
the vibe.
It'll be exciting to like continue your teaching work with these kids,
yeah,
or adults.
Out here in Vienna, I brought this painting that I've been working on for the last half a year on and off. I've taken it to a bunch of different festivals in the States, and I was working at a little bit in Amsterdam, and I'm finally getting closer to finishing it. I'm really stoked. It's done with the intention of bringing out the spiritual warrior in me, to be strong, to be out there in the world and fight with love and intelligence and just good vibes. So when I came to this workshop, I gave that project to all my students to paint their representations of their spiritual warrior within, or something that kind of symbolizes that energy and that intention. Because, you know, there's a lot of darkness in the world, and we gotta do our part, and we gotta have that warrior spirit, that strength to go out there and help heal it. So yeah, so far it's been very beautiful. It's been so nice here. Just very special people, and I'm blessed to be communing with them and helping them in any way to facilitate the project and their lives in any way I can. I think it's important for us people who want to be positive to experience the negative, you know? If we're just telling like, oh, positive is good, and that's all you're doing because you're being told, I mean, you gotta get to the dark too and get your fingers burned on the fire to know not to jump in the fire. And you learn that, you know, the negativity is depressing, and hurting people does not make you happy. And alcohols are depressive. So I was really like not very happy, and this is the kind of stuff that was coming out of me to express that.
You know, we don't want to live our life letting others validate us. But they, you know, that first article that we got in a magazine or newspaper makes us feel so like, yeah, I'm sharing this with the whole like world now, and it's really like an indicator that like your art's resonated enough for people to like, you know, invest into a page that's printed and stuff and sharing it with their community. Is it money? Is success money? That's really like an indicator, and how much of it. Like, will you, you know, when you buy your first Ferrari from your painting sales, then you'll be satisfied? I don't know, like some people never get satisfied, or maybe like we're dreaming on the wrong direction. But, you know, as I will get more into the next speech I have, the business of art, we shouldn't really feel here and be successful at money. Like, wanting money is not a negative thing in my books. I think we have a righteous job that harms nobody, that benefits many. So why shouldn't we be abundant in our lives? Why should we be sustained to have the power, to have the freedom to do whatever we want, to continue this life of self-expression and benefiting others? So if we have this money, we can travel wherever we go and meet the people that we will be helping with this art. So that whole starving artist thing, we got to throw it in the garbage. And yes, don't live your life only for the dollar, but you know, attract it and bring it to you and help you be you, you know, like do the things that you want.
To get around quicker without buying a normal skateboard, so okay. The price is right on this one. Thanks, man. Yeah. This is just the entrance and it's already pretty pimp. Wow, that's a lot of great art in that museum. A lot of celebrity paintings that I knew from my art history days, and I'm happy I got to see them in person. It's always nice to see all these famous paintings around the world. I'm gonna be checking out the Raphael show at the Albertini Museum. That was a pretty good show. Obviously, Raphael is a great painter, but I personally am not so into, you know, endless depictions of Jesus and the Virgin and all that stuff, despite its beautiful way of being portrayed. But there was a lot of other cool stuff in that museum that really caught my attention, so I, in general, enjoyed my visit to the Albertini Museum. Hey.
So I'm not really a masochist, but while I was here by myself with no dates to go out and just pretty much just teaching in school in one place, I decided to do the master cleanse. The master cleanse is a fast where you pretty much just drink juice, lemon juice with cayenne pepper and maple syrup for 10 days. After that, there's like a day of orange juice and a day of soups, and then slowly you get back on food. So it's kind of like 2 weeks of not eating solids. So that's gonna be tough, but I've done it before. I've done it a couple of times before, 10 years ago, and it was really good. It's cleansing, it was detoxifying. You wouldn't believe the things you continue to poo. Even though you're not putting food inside, you still get shit out, and that's actually something that I've been wanting to do, you know, lately, but I haven't had the chance because I'm always on the road. But now I'm a little bit more stable here in Vienna, so I'm doing the master cleanse for the next 10 days. It's gonna suck. I'm already kind of bummed, and I'm gonna throw the no food factor, but hey, what else is a spiritual warrior gonna do, huh?
I've come to the Belvedere Museum to check out the work of Gustav Klimt. Should be awesome. I'm a fan of his work and can't wait to see the gold leaf close up and all the beautiful brushstrokes. Butthole house. I always wanted to see a butthole house. So many perverts have been grabbing this statue's boobs that they're eroding away. Poor lady. Lady Griffin Bird. Klimt paintings that I expected, but there's also some really cool ones by Egon Schiele, so in general, it's been a nice afternoon. So today I'm coming to a whole different museum. It's the Ernst Fuchs Museum. Ernst Fuchs is like the forefather of the Vienna Academy of Visionary Arts. So it's gonna be a lot of like trippy, super fantastical art by one of the people who kind of like started this whole movement out here.
I met Ernst Fuchs in the year 2000. And I ended up becoming his assistant and working with him, my wife Florence Menard as well, as a personal assistant. And during that time I learned Misch technique, which is his revival of the classical technique of painting of the old masters. And then I started teaching it every summer, and that just expanded over the course of several years until I finally founded an academy here in Vienna. And the academy is dedicated basically to transmitting this Misch technique, or Ernst Fuchs' vision of painting. And it's not only a painting technique, but a whole world of how art is really reviving the sacred, reviving a view where visions will guide us into the future. We'll be right back.
coloring?
Yeah.
Why?
Because it's fun and you can show your imagination to your to the people you love, and also you can mess around with the colors. There's a lot of colors and pictures, and you can just copy stuff. It's just really fun.
Do you think you'll be an artist when you're older?
Yeah.
Nice.
Me too.
Good call. You guys are smart people. Oh, so many nice coloring jobs. You guys rule. Yeah, cover the camera, buddy. Don't let any of your hells shine. Very cool. Thanks, guys. Danke, Chen.
What is this?
Well, that is my shadow. It's my negative side that we all have, and I'm trying to externalize it so that I can give it some love and then not let it control me. So this painting I'm working here at the Academy is called Shadow Work. And I'm coming close to finishing it right now. I'm mixing a lot of mediums. I'm using gold leaf for the first time. I used my technique with the spray paint and the frottage. I also did a creature that's only one color with, you know, a couple shadings in it. But I usually go super colorful. In this case, I just kept them one kind of tone. So. You know, I've been trying to explore new ways of doing my own art since I'm pushing my students to be different and find new techniques and new ways. I felt like I had to do the same. Now, the topic of this theme, as the title indicates, is working with my shadow. So this is a portrait of my dark side, of my shadow, of my pain, of my sadness, of my negativity. And I felt it was important for me to, like, you know, bring him out, look at him, expose him, so that he won't be hidden behind my mind, controlling me or making me do things that I, the soul, don't want to do anymore. I want to be a good person, but I gotta be aware of this mind, of this entity that is not me, the soul, you know? And that's why I paint him, but I don't paint him to, like, humiliate him or fight him. I paint him so I can also give him some love, you know? So I can also make him look beautiful and recognize and give him some energy and let him purge, let out a lot of the anger and frustration and hatred that he might have in his existence. So it's been a hard painting to make emotionally, especially since I didn't eat for 10 days during the process and going through the heartbreak of, you know, not having a Rianne in my life anymore. And, you know, but it's been very healing, and it's certainly, like, helping me a lot become a better person, which I think is the mission of art. It's day 6 of my juice fast. I'm feeling pretty okay today, a little bit more energy in the last couple days. And I will be doing a demo for my class. Yes, this is Clovis. And I'll be spray painting this mural today, so should be fun. Wish me luck. We'll be right back.
to have my students help me out doing the fill-ins as part of their class, and it saves me some time. Today is day 11 of my cleanse. So today is all orange juice day. And I've come to this spot here to get a colon cleanse, which I believe is when a doctor shoots a bunch of water up your ass to get everything out of your guts. So let's hope this is not too painful.
The colonic is the last part of our guts where we excrete our feces. And in many cases, you can have pouches, which is sacs in the colon, in which you can have a gathering of stool. And when you are doing a fast, this is just a thing. What you, even if you have a very very healthy colon, just makes sense to get rid of toxins. That's why I would recommend it during a fast, just one time.
Number two is going out.
Okay.
And cold or warm water coming in and coming out.
Ah.
Okay.
So there's warm water going in and then shit coming out.
Six warm water and three cold water. And it's like a massage, this colon. And everything is coming out.
All right.
Okay.
Cool. Do I get to see what comes out?
Excuse me?
Do I get to see what comes out?
Yes.
Nice. We'll see what happens.
Well, I don't know why I was guessing that getting a colonic was going to be an okay experience. I didn't anticipate getting a tube shoved deep up my ass was actually going to be an unpleasurable experience, but it was. The water going in and out of my intestines wasn't so bad, and all in all, I'm happy I did it because apparently a lot of old poo came out of there, and you know, I don't need that shit in me anymore. So, good experience, even though it wasn't that fun.
Now to the t-shirt shop to get a little demonstration and be able to make our own t-shirts in this awesome super workshop of ours.
Transfer my art for a graphic.
Fierce.
pretty badass. So yeah, like a normal looking building's not as cool as these super old school ones. All right, today we're at a market. Just gonna enjoy the weekend. Should be fun. It's pretty. This is the most badass pipe you can see.
From Canada, it's a little bit easier.
Thank you.
Thanks, man. Just bought these cool Ernst Fuchs dishes. I actually do know Ernst Fuchs. I was just tricking you so you give me a better price. But you see, she is nice after all. Yay, thank you.
Yeah, we are at Naschmarkt. No? It's like a market with different things from Austria or from different countries. You can just find it here and buy things that you normally won't find in supermarkets and stuff.
Alright, here's some of the things that I bought at the flea market. My Ernst Fuchs plate. I got these like cool antlers that I might do like a sculpture or something. These are only like 10 euros. A Sega Genesis for 10 euros. This is awesome. I'm really excited about this one. It's gonna be fun. Yay, for John.
Legal walls, so I'm gonna check out the art they got out here. It's good to see some street art.
Spiritual warrior, I thought what would be more appropriate than to represent it as an artifact, you know, transforming the old warrior into the new warrior.
At the moment I'm doing a study on astro-shamanic astrology, which is experiential astrology, and so my spirit warrior is someone who relates to the sun and the moon and is an intent towards extending experience of being on this planet influenced by other planets.
This is a great gift, this place. It's been a dream come true for me to be able to come here and connect with the lineage of old masters that I saw from afar, you know, and I studied. To be able to come here feels like coming home. And the artists that are here are really devoted. It's a great gift to be able to be with the teachers who have gone on a really beautiful journey and are bringing that back to people to learn. Yeah, it's been pretty awesome.
I got here and just I've been blown away by all the people from around the world I've met. The students alone have taught me so much on top of all of what, you know, the teachers have taught me as well. Also, you know, the studio is just amazing. You walk in every morning, it feels like home. You know, you've got the rugs, you've got the good vibes, and kind of back and forth on concepts, and then after doing a rapé session, I kind of had a vision along with kind of a lot of like the Peruvian music was that was getting played, kind of led to this more tribal feeling and energy that I was picking up on.
Well, my painting is about the power of the creative act, the joy that comes with creating. And I guess I was just trying to capture the feeling of putting the paintbrush to the canvas.
I would say when I came to Spiritual Warrior, I thought of the being that represented, and I kind of got this being removing his face to like remove his own ego and judgment to restore balance to everything. I've learned a lot when it comes to how to like block in and then refine with acrylics.
So this painting is my spiritual warrior. It's sort of a manifestation of playfulness and joy in my life, but also through the process of painting it, I discovered this symbol of the tree alone, which sort of represents my struggle to be more independent.
I think that the Vienna Academy of Visionary Art is really fantastic because you get to meet working artists as teachers for sometimes up to 3 months, and you really get to know them on a personal level, which is super valuable. And you also get to know all of their special techniques. And it's also a place where you can be encouraged to work on a painting for 3 months at a time, which is incredible.
Well, it's starting to snow out here in Vienna. It's starting to look a lot like Montreal, so it's time for me to go and move on to the next location. So I hope you enjoyed this episode. I invite you to check out the next one. We'll be in a warmer location. This time I'll be in Cuba doing some nice activities with kids and skateboarding, and it's gonna be a blast. Can't wait. All right, have a good one. Peace.
This episode, please click like and also subscribe so you can catch my future episodes. Have a good one. Peace.